and welcome to Serena Speaks. And in this video, I'm going to go through NICE versus BTS, so the British Thoracic Society's guidelines on asthma, because there are subtle differences between the two. Now, the BNF publications are based on NICE guidelines, but they do mention BTS within there as well. So hopefully for the pre-reg exam, they would state which guidelines they want you to refer to when answering a question. At least fingers crossed that's what they do. So let's learn the subtle differences between the two of them to help familiarise ourselves a bit more. So I think one of the key differences between NICE versus BTS is actually the agings and the age groups that they classify those that are an adult and those that are a child. So for NICE, they state that anyone over the age of 17 is an adult, therefore anyone under the age of 17 is classified as a child. That varies very differently to BTS because they say anyone is a child under the age of 12, so it's quite a key difference. Another difference is the way that they categorise and classify inhaled corticosteroid doses. So whereas NICE will say low, moderate and high, BTS will say low, medium and high. So moderate and medium, that's where the difference is over there. Now with this video, we're going to look at adults, children over 5 and children under 5. Now with the NICE guidelines, their guidelines for adults and children over 5 are actually very quite similar, and the same can be said with the BTS guidelines for adults and children over 5 as well. But we'll still look at all of those situations. Now, when it comes to regular preventive therapy, both NICE and BTS will state that an inhaled corticosteroid is recommended in patients who are having to use their short-acting beta-2 agonist, or their SABA, more than 3 times a week, or 3 times a week and more, if they're symptomatic for at least 3 times a week or more, and if they're waking up with nighttime symptoms. And the BTS guidelines will also go on to say that they recommend that the inhaled corticosteroid dose should be given twice a day, or the same total daily dose can be given once a day, but only really in milder conditions or if there is good complete control of asthma that has been established. So moving on to initial add-on therapy. So this is where it can get very different between NICE and BTS. So with our NICE guidelines, they'll say start on an inhaled corticosteroid. If that isn't helping, then add on a leukotriene receptor antagonist, or an LTRA, and then later on the patient will be reviewed. That's very different to the BTS guidelines, which say have your inhaled corticosteroid and instead add on a long-acting beta-2 agonist. So whilst NICE guidelines say add on an LTRA, the BTS guidelines will say add on a LABA. So now let's look at additional add-on therapy. So our patient is on their ICS, they have their LTRA added on, but actually their asthma is still being uncontrolled. So in this situation, we might swap our patient to an ICS and a LABA in a combination inhaler with or without that LTRA. If the patient's asthma is still being uncontrolled, then that combination inhaler of our ICS and our LABA might be changed to a MART instead, a maintenance and reliever therapy, which is essentially an ICS with a fast-acting LABA. And this might be given with a low dose of an ICS. Now, if the patient who's on that MART and that low dose of ICS, their asthma is still being uncontrolled, then that low dose ICS might be cranked up a notch to a moderate dose instead. And again, if this is still being uncontrolled, then that moderate dose of ICS will be cranked up another notch to a high dose. And the patient then might be trialled with another medicine. So for example, a LAMA, a long-acting muscarinic antagonist, or even modified release theophylline. So that's with the NICE guidelines. So now this is very different to what the BTS guidelines say. So with our BTS guidelines, we have our ICS, we have our LABA. If this is inadequate though, then that ICS dose should be increased to a medium dose. But again, if this is inadequate, then you would revert back to a low dose of ICS with that LABA, and you would add on an additional medicine, such as an LTRA, a LAMA, or modified release theophylline. Again, if the patient's having no response to the LABA, then that should be discontinued based on the BTS guidelines, and instead increase the inhaled corticosteroid dose to a medium dose. But again, if this is ineffective, let's revert back to a low dose of an ICS and add on an LTRA or a LAMA. I know, it's a lot to take in, so just breathe. It's all good. We'll get through this. It's one of those things where you'll probably have to re-go over it several times, but you'll get there. I promise you, you'll get there. So then there's a heading within the BNF that says high dose of inhaled corticosteroids and further add-on treatment. And this is specific again to the BTS guidelines. And what it says is that if a patient with asthma, their asthma isn't controlled with their short-acting beta-2 agonist using it when required, it's not being controlled with their medium dose of their inhaled corticosteroid plus their LABA, then in these situations, that inhaled corticosteroid dose should be increase a notch to a high dose, and another medication should be added. So either an LTRA, tiotropium, so a LAMA, modified release theophylline, and by this point the patient would be seeking specialist advice. So that was for adults. Now we're going to move on to children over 5. And as previously mentioned, NICE guidelines state that anyone under the age of 17, so if you're 16 and under, you are considered a child. Whereas with the BTS guidelines, they have their children as anyone under 12. So those are over 12, they're then considered as an adult. So with our NICE guidelines, they have pediatric low dose, moderate dose, and high dose. Whereas with BTS, for those that are 5 to 12 years old, they will have very low dose, and medium dose. And for those that are 12 and over, so our adults, as we mentioned before, it'll be low, medium, and high. So when it comes to regular therapy is the same as what it is for adults. So in that, a patient will be started an inhaled corticosteroid if they're using their short-acting beta-2 agonist more than 3 times a week, if they're symptomatic with their asthma more than 3 times a week, or if they're experiencing nighttime awakening. So it's the same as what it was for the adults. Now, in terms of initial add-on therapy, again, same as what it was for the adults. So with our NICE guidelines, you have your inhaled corticosteroid and you may add on then an LTRA if the inhaled corticosteroid on its own isn't benefiting the patient. That's with NICE. Whereas with BTS, they will say that if a child is over 12, then and they're not, the ICS isn't adequate, then we're going to add on a LABA, so same as the adult. Whereas for a child that is between the ages of 5 and 12, they will either add on a LABA or an LTRA. So in terms of additional add-on therapy, when we're looking at our NICE guidelines, so our patient is on an ICS, they're on an LTRA, this is still not benefiting them, we're going to then say goodbye to the LTRA and add on a LABA instead. So this differs ever so slightly to the adult version, which said that you would have your ICS, you would have your LTRA. If the LTRA didn't help, then you would add on a LABA, use that in a combination inhaler with or without the LTRA. Whereas for children over 5 based on NICE guidelines, it will be the ICS and LTRA. LTRA isn't helping, so we're going to say bye, and it'll be the LABA instead. So we've got our ICS and our LABA. So we're not even having the option of having an LTRA along with it. If this doesn't help, then we're going to have our MART, we're going to have our maintenance and reliever therapy, along with a low dose or pediatric low dose of the ICS. If this doesn't help, we're going to crank up that dose a notch to a moderate dose. If that moderate dose of ICS still doesn't help, then at this point, specialist advice would be sought, and that might be cranked up to a high dose instead, and it may end up being that the child is prescribed an additional medicine, such as modified release theophylline. Now, with our BTS guidelines, though, they will vary, or the route that the additional add-on therapy that the patient will have will vary depending on if the patient is getting any benefit from their LABA. So we started off with an ICS and a LABA. Say that that LABA is providing some benefit, but their control still isn't quite adequate, then we might increase the ICS dose from a very low dose to a low dose. If we though find that this is still ineffective, then we're going to revert that low dose of ICS back to a very low dose, and we might add on another medicine such as an LTRA or modified release theophylline. Whereas if actually their LABA isn't really providing them any benefit, then we're going to say goodbye to it. It's going to be discontinued. We're going to continue the patient on that ICS, and we might increase their dose from a very low dose to a low dose. But again, if this is ineffective, then we're going to revert back to that very low dose of ICS and add on another medicine such as an LTRA. So then in terms of high doses of inhaled corticosteroids and further add-on treatments, so we have our patient, they're taking their SABA when required, they're on their low dose of inhaled corticosteroid, they're on their additional medicine, which is usually a LABA, but actually they're still not getting the benefit that they require, then we might increase the ICS dose to a medium dose. We might add on an LTRA or modified release theophylline, but this is the point where specialist advice would then be sought. So moving on to children under 5, so the BNF states that if a child is using more than one SABA a month, then their asthma needs to be urgently reviewed. NICE guidelines classify their inhaled corticosteroids for children under 5 as pediatric low doses or moderate doses, whereas BTS just classify it as very low dose. That's it. No other categories with BTS when it comes to children under 5. So with our NICE guidelines, if a child is having symptoms more than 3 times a week, if they're waking up at night time, or if with asthma symptoms, or it appears that actually their asthma isn't being controlled with a SABA alone, then they will be trialled for 8 weeks with a moderate dose of an ICS. If this doesn't appear to be helping, then an LTRA will probably be added. If again this isn't benefiting, then that LTRA will probably be stopped, and this is when an asthma specialist, their advice would be sought. Whereas with the BTS guidelines, they say that a very low dose of an ICS will be trialled if a child is symptomatic more than 3 times a week, if they're waking up with any nighttime symptoms with their asthma, or if they're using their SABA more than 3 times a week. So it differs ever so slightly with that bit with BTS, because NICE would just say in general, if a child, their symptoms aren't being adequately controlled with a SABA inhaler, or a suspected asthma is not being controlled with their SABA alone, then you would trial the inhaled corticosteroid, whereas BTS guidelines say that if that SABA is being used more than 3 times a week or 3 times a week or more, that's when an ICS should be introduced. And again, if this isn't providing enough benefit, then actually, or if the child is unable to have an inhaled corticosteroid, then actually an LTRA would be given instead. So there you have it, the differences between NICE and BTS, which is now both written in the BNF. So fingers crossed, if they're going to ask that question in the exam, that they will stipulate which guideline they want you to use, or better yet, it would be a resource pack type question where they would actually stipulate which guidelines that they want you to use to answer the question. But as you can see, in some situations, it's quite subtle differences. In other situations, it's quite major differences. So I do think it's an idea to learn both of them, and hopefully this video you found useful, and actually it summarised that for you. So I do hope that you liked this video, and if you did, why not give it a thumbs up? Share, like, subscribe. Do also visit my Facebook, Instagram and Twitter page. And until next time, good luck with your revision and have your revisings!